It's 1 o'clock on a lovely May afternoon. I'm at probably one of London's cutest tube stations, Kew Gardens. It's interesting how the onboard announcement actually announced it as Kew Garden without the S. TfL, add the S. I've just tapped in with my Oyster card at one of the new ticket machines that's here. And the balance, it says, is £4.80. And I'm here to make a journey through Zone 1 for £1.50, which you're not supposed to be able to do, but I have a hunch, for reasons that shall become clear, that this is one of the few journeys that you can do on the tube where you travel through Zone 1 and don't pay the peak fare. You don't pay the higher fare that you would normally get charged for travelling through Zone 1. And although Kew Gardens is cute and quiet and peaceful, it is also on the Heathrow flight path, so you do get some planes sometimes. Anyway, train's in 4 minutes. Let's see how much it costs me.
This is Kew Gardens.
Kew Gardens.
The next station is Gurnsbury.
It's got an S. Okay, so, got my tube map. Now the deal is that normally any journey through Zone 1 and you pay £2.70 for an off-peak journey, but due to the London Overground and the fact that you can go from, well, anywhere in that branch of Gunnersbury, Kew Gardens or Richmond round to Highbury and Islington on the Overground, I don't think the system knows whether to charge you for going through Zone 1 or whether it gives you the benefit of the doubt and assumes that you've gone on the Overground via Willesden Junction, and when you therefore touch out at Highbury and Islington, it charges you the Overground fare as opposed to the fare if you go through Zone 1 on the Underground. I'm definitely getting the District Line to Victoria, and then I'll go up the Victoria Line to Highbury and Islington that way, touch out, and I think it would have charged me the lower fare. Pick. Ready. Let's see how much it costs.
Please do not leave cases or parcels unattended anywhere on the station.
I got to Highbury and Islington and touched out, but I came up to Frensley Park just so I could get the Thames Link home and have a whole declassified first class to myself. So it did only cost me £1.50. So I touched in here at Kew Gardens, came up on the District Line, changed to Victoria, went through Zone 1, so very clearly got a train, Victoria Line through Zone 1, touched out at Highbury and Islington, and it only cost me £1.50 because the system doesn't know if I went via Willesden Junction or not. I had wondered, does it take 10 minutes longer to go via the Overground, whether there was like a time thing, like if I went too quickly on the Victoria Line, would it know then that I'd taken the tube? The point is, all this happens because of the London Overground, and because none of the London Overground goes through Zone 1. So, my challenge to you, comments below, there are others. I know of at least two others. Are there more? Can you work out the other two? What are the two journeys, or are there any other journeys that I don't know of, which using the London Overground, because it doesn't go through Zone 1, what other through Zone 1 journeys can you make where the system has to assume that you might have taken the Overground and not gone through Zone 1, and therefore charges you the lower fare of off-peak £1.50 rather than £2.70? Good luck.